I think it's so poetic, is the only word I can think of, to open with you as a conductor, conducting the box suite in Avery Fisher Hall, and then we conclude 3 days later in a late night concert, conducting the Stravinsky Octet in the Kaplan Penthouse at 11 o'clock at night with the moon and stars of New York in a very intimate piece. And how do you feel about that arc?
I'm starting with the wonderful Moseley Mozart Orchestra, with Bach, and doing this complete journey and also experiencing the Ice Ensemble for Dumbarton Oaks. I know they are so enthusiastic and they have fire and they have curiosity and virtuosity. It's really fantastic.
Do you want to talk a little bit about the Stravinsky Piano Concerto, which we're also doing on that program with Peter Serkin performing?
It's another wonderful piece which I don't know why is not so often performed. And he is one of the greatest and profound and truth-seeking artists I've ever met. And this concerto is part of the neoclassical period of Stravinsky, and so links very well with Dumbarton Oaks, and I'm really very lucky to be doing it with Peter again.
It's so beautiful to be concluding your engagement with the Stravinsky Octet.
This lovely jewel by Stravinsky is a piece I love because it's one of the first pieces I did when I was very young. And this is one of the first Stravinsky I conducted. So it's very special to end with that piece. And I remember I read some time ago what Stravinsky told about the piece. And he said that one night he had a dream, and in that dream, a group of musicians were playing light, joyful music. So when he woke up in the morning, he just sat and wrote that music.